And it's just a dance where the dancers perform as they wish. They go anywhere they want to go, and it's just a greeting dance. The gentleman you see on the screen now is in his 80s. As you can see by his movements and actions, he has led a very active life and is still quite active. He is from Minnesota. We have a lot of visitors that come here every year from different tribes, different states. This gentleman, who is performing the pipe dance at the moment, has won many prizes in the past. He has a large family of about 10 or 11 children. He is in his 40s. As you can see by his movements, he is very talented. This is what is known as a swan dance. It describes the movements and the sailing of the swan over the waters, as you can see by the movements of the arms of the dancers. It's just telling in dance the beauty and the gracefulness of the swan. This is known as the rabbit dance. It is a fairly new dance, and we have just adopted this from the Plains Indians just shortly after the Second World War. It is quite similar to square dancing, only without the collar. They have partners, and they move in various different directions, and towards the latter part of the dance, they will speed up and go quite fast, which is sort of as a climax to the dance.
We're talking with Mrs. Iva Roy from Davenport, Iowa. She is going to describe the costume she is wearing and tell us the significance of some of the apparel she is wearing. Iva?
Well, I'll start with the feather that is stuck behind my headband. The feather symbolizes a woman or a girl. She has the right to wear such a feather, which is an eagle tip, a red-tipped eagle feather, because of the fact that she has a brother or a husband who has been in the war and back. And now the headband is just as a decoration to hold the hair back. And the designs on the headband, a lot of the designs that we use on our costumes have been adopted from other tribes. Our particular tribe, the Meskwakis, have flowers and vines on their on all their costumes. But we have, through the years, we have adopted other designs from the Sioux tribes, the Plains, and the Southwest Indians, which are more symmetrical and straight lines and squares, as you can see on the headband and on the necklace that I'm wearing. The other necklace that I'm wearing is made out of shin bone of deer. This particular necklace was handed down to me, my grandmother, on my mother's side. And it is a very old necklace. It contains beads that were brought up the Mississippi River by the traders, by the French traders. And it's a very old piece. And the style of the blouse and the skirt is typical of the Meskwakis of Tama. And the moccasins that I'm wearing are Chippewa moccasins. I'm married to a Chippewa from Minnesota, and he brought these down from Minnesota as a gift to me. As you will notice, the pattern on my skirt is a flower design, and that's typical of the Woodlands Indians.
Iva, is the same thing true of the men and their costumes, the significance of them?
Yes, as far as the designs go, the headdresses, the type of headdress that they wear on their heads distinguishes the different tribes. Some tribes will wear just a small roach, and there's other tribes, like the Southwest tribes, the Sioux and, the Plains Indians, the Sioux and the Blackfeet, who will wear the full headdress with all the feathers and the long trails. The Woodlands Indians wear mostly just a roach and with a feather out of the top of the middle, out of the on top.
About how many dancers would you say are here at the Tama Powwow?
Well, I would estimate approximately 500 dancers at the moment. There might be more coming in later because there's usually other tribes coming in from other states.
And how many tribes altogether would this represent then?
Oh, I figure about 12 to 15 different tribes. This dance is known as the Friendship Dance. It is usually the first dance that is done during any gathering of several tribes or families. This dance is known as the pipe dance. It, as you will notice, it requires great skill and coordination on the part of the dancer. And it is a very difficult dance to do, as you have to keep in time to the singers, and the beat of the drum changes from one beat to another. Usually, young men are the ones that dance this dance. It is offering the sacred pipe, a peace pipe, to the four winds and to Mother Earth and the sky.
Thank you.
Okay, well, thank you very much for talking with us. Mrs. Iva Roy from Davenport, Iowa.
You're welcome.
I'll wait till they do that.